Sir Lanval put other knights to shame, no braver man than he. He had no coin unto his name, so he rode off to the country. He got off his horse and he let him run in a field by a bubbling stream. He tucked his cloak up under his head, drifted off to a worrisome dream. He drifted off to a worrisome dream. There were two girls when he awoke, they were finer than he'd ever seen. Wearing long tunics of indigo, they were richer than any queen. Come with us, those maidens said to Lanval as he lay. He shot up quick, didn't miss a lick, and they got off on their way. And three were on their way. So fine, better than a king could buy. Lanval knelt and he peeked inside, not knowing just what he'd find. A lady lay all dressed in white, smelling sweeter than a summertime rose. She left her land for a courtly night, and Sir Lanval she chose. 'Twas Sir Lanval she chose. Lady spoke unto the knight, there's none as handsome as thee, and I'd be willing to treat you right if you would lay with me. There's nothing in which I can't afford, she said to Sir Lanval. I'll make you as rich as any lord, but you can't tell a soul. I know you can't tell a soul. Lanval's heart was struck by a spark that set his spirit on fire. He said, what you ask, my love, will be my true desire. Now Lanval will be the kind of man to stay true to his every word. He left the lady smiling man and a whistling like a bird. King Arthur's wife was fair and bright, but got it into her head to lure Sir Lanval in some night and get him into her bed. Your husband is my king and lord, said Lanval, just the same. Not for you or for your love will I dishonor his name. I'll never dishonor his name. Like women, you don't like me, man, then you'd prefer. Sir Lanval said, my lady, please, and turned it back on her. For I have a love in all the world more fair than you by far. Even the least of her servant girls are twice the queen you are. They're twice the queen you are. When the king caught wind of this, for he heard a different tune sung by the queen, for the truth was missed, and Sir Lanval was doomed. So he called up about three of his men and sent them after the knight. If he can't afford my corporal, then we'll string him up tonight. For we'll string him up tonight. Then went the three in search for he who mourned for his lost love. Sat alone in misery, feeling cursed by the Lord above. They found him there in his despair and brought him back to the king. Said, Lanval, you mustn't dare to dishonor my queen. You dishonor my queen. Sir Lanval spoke to the king and said, you only got half the truth. Take your wife, I never intend, but I lost my only crew. For the one I love is not your queen, but one more noble and fair. Because of my words I haven't seen, she vanished in the air. Yeah, she vanished in the air. up all of his men and brought the knight to trial, to make him pay for his evil sins in a bitter fit of denial. And just before the court was ruled and Lanval's fate was sealed, two beautiful girls on Spanish mules rode up the truth revealed. The truth was then revealed. All the men who were standing around looked up to the furious king and said, on account of the truth we found, won't charge him with a thing. Those girls, though they're twice as fair as a queen, said Sir Lanval, for I still have my cross to bear. I know not them at all, for I know not them at all. Tired of waiting round for the court to come to an end, went on a white pony riding into town, Sir Lanval to defend. 'Twas a lady all dressed in white and fair beyond the queen. The king and all his knights agreed that Sir Lanval be free, Sir Lanval be free. She's my lady, she's my love, said Lanval to the crowd. She's the one I boasted of, the reason I was proud. He held on tight to his love, he held on to his love.